Imagine wanting to relive memories like stopping clocks by their hands. Every minute they try to second guess my love for them. Because I've been told that my love is like a clock, endless. So I'm gonna end the rest of my time and allow the cracks in my judgment to be filled with overflowing pages of words from the divine, filling me up to the brim till I want no more. I desire this heel-shaped mentality that often wants to stomp my vulnerability into the ground, to erupt symphonies of melodious tunes that will tune out my loony thoughts that want to have me chained up and bound like jail cells that have stood in front of my way from freedom and myself. How can I tell these bars that I need their help to give me the key to drill holes in the parts of me that are searching for a love that can only be found in God? A love that can only be found by planting seeds in good soil, but so often, how about trying to go back to Eden where my Genesis was really in front of my face, enticing me with served pence that said in God we trust, but that the value was lower than a quarter, and took the quarter back to the 50-yard line and couldn't receive this wide perception that this interception was deeper than the tackle in front of them. I lost myself in a game I was never ready to play, only to enter into another game at the free throw line. I put up shots that should have been done with no guards in my face, because I needed the space to block out the noise, the space to build up my form, and to weather the storm between who I wanted to become and who I really was. And it was on that day that I made this declaration, that I will no longer conform to the pressure that I feel in this room.
Yeah.
I will not keep quiet to make you feel comfortable because it's my comfortability that's killing you. I've been watching you die slowly and I've been the one enabling you. It's almost as if I've given you the gun in your hand and I'm the voice telling you to shoot you. I'm not your friend, but don't tell you the truth. So let me tell you that I'm more than what meets the eye. I'm the definition of black and white. There are no 50 shades of gray Christians.
Well.
And I say all this because I've heard one too many voices in my lifetime telling me to get on the sideline. And as I ran baseline to baseline, this suicide is what allowed me to flatline. So my message will stay the same because Christ, he freed me from these chains.
Yeah.
And I will continue to say his name till he heals you of these pains. Okay.